Welcome to Wednesday Wisdom, a weekly devotion following the F260 Bible reading plan. This week we're in the book of Nehemiah, chapter 8. Well, Nehemiah probably has you thinking of several different things. Obviously, you think about Nehemiah going from a cupbearer to the king, all the way to this builder of the wall and doing all these great things for the nation of Israel as they return back from exile. But here in chapter 8, and as we saw in chapter 1, Nehemiah is very much a book of repentance. Here we see that they have found the law, and Ezra gets up to read the law, and we see what happens. It says, all the people came together as one in the square before the water gate. They told Ezra, the teacher of the law, to bring out the book of the law of Moses, which the Lord had commanded for Israel. So on the first day of the seventh month, Ezra the priest brought the law before the assembly, which was made up of men and women, all who were able to understand. So this is from young to old, all who were able to understand. He read it aloud from daybreak till noon. So we're thinking from the very morning all the way till noon, as he faced the square before the water gate in the presence of the men, women, and others who could understand. And all the people listened attentively to the book of the law. And so Ezra, he went up onto this wooden platform and he read from the law. And then it goes on to tell us all the people who heard. And this is what they said in verse 5. Ezra opened the book. All the people could see him because he was standing above them. And as he opened it, the people all stood up. Ezra praised the Lord, the great God, and all the people lifted their hands and responded, Amen, Amen. Then they bowed down and worshiped the Lord with their faces to the ground. So first thing we see here is just this reverence for the Word of God. You know, we're privileged to have such easy access to the Bible. Have you thought about it? You can turn your phone on right now and you can read any translation that you want to, all sorts of commentaries, but you can read God's Word whenever you want. But these people, they didn't have access, and when they heard it for the first time in quite a while, they were reverenced. Here's what they did. Verse 9, then Nehemiah the governor, Ezra the priest, the teacher of the law, and the Levites who instructed the people said to them all, this day is holy to the Lord your God. Do not mourn or weep, for all the people had been weeping as they listened to the words of the law. The first thing they do is they began to repent, and we see later on that there is great repentance over their sin and the people's sin as they saw that they weren't necessarily matching up to God's word. This is what Nehemiah says to him. Don't mourn, don't repent. Why? He says, go and enjoy choice foods and sweet drinks and send some to those who have nothing prepared. The day is holy to our Lord. Do not grieve, for the joy of the Lord is your strength. The Levites calmed all the people saying, be still, for this is a holy day. Do not grieve. Well, this is a wonderful day because they have recovered God's word. They are reading from God's word, hearing God speak to them. You know, we have to think, do you have reverence for God's word? Now, we may not be reading from morning to daybreak, day after till noon, day after day like they were, but do you have reverence for the word of God? Have you made it a priority in your life? This is not a condemning thing, but it's just a wonderful opportunity that we have as believers to actually hear from God. Sometimes I think about that. It's like we say all these amazing things about the Bible, that it's God's word to us and for us, that it instructs us in life and in faith. But then sometimes we don't actually put it into practice and actually open up our Bibles and hear God speak to us. So let's take their example. Yes, some of us, that may be mourning and weeping, but more than that, let's think about the blessings that we have in Christ, who we are because of what he's done, and actually hear from him every day. And from that, grow deeper and deeper in our understanding for Christ and what he's done for us and how we should live in light of that truth. Well, thank you for joining me for Wednesday Wisdom. I hope to see you next week. Have a blessed week.